why I thought I was white for a long time. A long time. And it was tragic growing up because I couldn't sing, I couldn't dance, I had bad credits. And it's just tragic though, you know, it's tragic. It really is. But I have a lot of white friends, as you can see. It was like, there's a black guy on stage and he just sounds white. He's tricking us. Is he a magician as well? He obviously must be, because right now he's not a comedian. That's right. No, I'm joking. But they can put your hands together for all the diversity that we have going on in the world. And if you're not clapping, I'm just assuming that you're saying hail racism in your brain. But it's funny, man, because like it's 2017. We got black people, we got white people in the same building. Y'all clap it up with that, because it's really awesome. And we're in trying times we quite haven't made it there yet, have we? We just quite haven't made it there. Black people, white people, we're the same people, but we have two different problems. We have completely different problems. Like black people, as black people, we have to deal with police brutality. Some of us have to deal with like crack cocaine. And others have to deal with things like bad credit, right? Yeah, it happens. Now, white people, they have a totally different plethora of other problems that they have to deal with. Like, they have to deal with, like, gluten. They have to deal with the improper seasoning for their food recipes. And they have to deal with a more tragic thing that, you know, most black people have to deal with, right? Identity theft. Deal with them. But I have a life hack for all you white people. Sir, I have a life hack for you. Ma'am, my lady. Having bad credit eliminates the threat of identity theft every single time. Every single time. Because I promise, when these people call me and was like, Mr. Williams, we have a credit card for you. I'm like, do you now? That's where that song ran off on the plug twice. Yeah. Anybody got student loans? I'm never gonna pay those shits back. Ever. It's like Sally Mae's like, I mean, how old is that bitch? She gotta be like 90 years old, right? She can't catch me. There's no way in the world. She follows, that's all right. So she follows at a safe distance. I'm like, treat you, bitch. And now that I know. No, I have to, man, put your hands together if you got like 40 addresses. You got bills and like 40 different. Everybody else? Like, that's the damn thing around. Just trying to. Then he has this bearded man recording everything. No way. I'd rather not. Put your hands together. You might got kids. Put your hands together. You got kids. I got kids, man. That lady's lightly clapping. She's like, yeah, I came to this comedy show to forget about the motherfucker. I got kids, man. Kids trip me out. Man, y'all remember back in the day, man? You remember back in the day, kids used to talk about each other like your mama, right? I remember I joked this one kid. I was like, man, you're fat. And he was like, your mama, bitch. I was like, oh, that shit hurt real deep because my mom really is bad. And, I mean, there's nothing I can do about that. I mean, she had the same food choices as everyone else. Access to the same gym memberships. It's her damn fault. I love my mom, man. She hates that damn joke. Man. That's why I just have to keep making it. I mean, I'm just saying, man. She did some great stuff for me. She gave me breath. Y'all put your hands together for your mom. The only stipulation to that joke is that every check that comes out of that joke goes directly to her. Like Cardi B, yes, I pay my mama's bills. No, I don't. That comes out of mama's bills. There's absolutely nothing. Doesn't even put a damn dent in that car note. So these kids these days are vicious, man, and they disrespectful. and I don't tolerate the disrespect. But I heard one kid say that to the other kid, and he was like, so? I will step away from this white child. But then he said something that just struck me as odd. He was like, at least you don't see my mother's boobies out on Facebook. And I was like, that? I was like, ooh. I said, I know that hurt. I said, you go in the corner. Come here, Tiger. Look here, I heard what he said about your mother, and that was really mean, but, can you tell me what your mom's name is on Facebook? Double R? Tell her she got a friend request coming. Double tap on the back. Oh, no, you don't have to worry about him now. I'd be just happy now. I got kids, man, and man, I want y'all to put your, I really want people to book me because, like, honestly, man, all jokes aside, 100% of my proceeds, it goes to feeding hungry kids. I also shelter them, and I also clothe them right here in Little Rock, Arkansas. So, y'all put your hands together for that because, like, I mean, this is something I've been doing. It's a mission of mine. I don't want any children hungry, but what I don't tell these people that these are all my damn kids. That's neither here nor there. I need you to support this local comedy. As the rap song says, I have a family to feed. You know, and they be dependent on me. It's a true statement. So, if this comedy didn't hit you, the sermon. Amen. But, man, my kids trip me out, man. I really love my kids to death, man. Yeah. Enough about them, though. But, y'all remember, put your hands together if you're broke, man. I've been broke lately. You know what I'm saying? I've been broke. I'm not ashamed to say it. That's why I need to support this comedy. I don't think y'all been broke like me. Like, I've been real broke, man. Anybody got broke parents in the house? Yeah. Parents that aren't clapping must be the broke or be the cheap parents. But I got, I'm broke, and it trips me out because, like, I be going to the gas station, and I be trying to be all incognito, and I be like, listen here. I said, look here, bro, let me get, 27 on pump 2. He's like, you want, $20 on pump 2? I said, no, brother, let me get 20 cents on pump 2. I was like, well, sir, do you plan to go to pump 4? I said, look here, brother, get my business. Like, dang, man. But have you ever been so broke that homeless people want to mess with you? I was downtown the other day, man, and tripped me out, and I seen this homeless guy, man. I see him all the time, man. I was like, hey, brother, what's up? He's like, oh, no. I said, what's wrong? He said, no habla, broke, negro. I said, okay, you don't understand broke black people? See. I said, okay, I said, understand this, all of me. I said, I voted for Trump. Wall. Grande wall. Mucho grande. He didn't like that joke and he stabbed me. I was like, okay. But I was like, but anybody, but like, during the election, was anybody feeling the burn? Any Bernie Sanders fans in here? Yeah. Woo! I was too, and I was like, feeling it burning. Doctor said I might need to go get that shit checked out. I was like, okay. I'm gonna throw that joke in the trash. But it's speaking while we're on this tip, man, I actually got a friend that's a doctor, man, and he trips me out, and we go golfing together and snowboarding and other white activities. And he was like, hey, I remember one time, I got real sick, and I went in there, and he checked me out, and came out. He's like, I got good news and bad news. I was like, well, lay on the good news first. And it was like, because of the skinny jeans you're wearing, you have a male yeast infection. I was like, quit playing around. He was like, and the neighbors think I'm selling jokes. Play it with me, man. He's like, okay, no, all jokes aside, though. For real, I ran the test back, and Yeah, you have AIDS.
I was like,
are you gonna stop playing anytime soon? He was like, I'm just joshing. You have Ebola. Okay, you have the flu. You have the flu. You really have the flu. Not really, you have AIDS. I was like, man, what? So I immediately got another doctor, okay, and a second opinion. But that's a true story, and yeah. No! I was attempting to have sex with somebody here tonight. No, I don't have AIDS, okay? I don't have AIDS. It's like a special victims unit, you know? It's like some of these stories may be true. The names have been changed around. These is this man's jokes. But speaking of which, I guess a little bit more about myself. I've been black for a while now. Anybody else? No. Yeah. All your life? Oh, man. She's all my life I had to copy. Yes, if you're black, yes. Yes, only black people. White guys, like, they had the fight. I've never seen them in any type of debacle of any sort. Debacle, yes. But, I'm 32 years old, and I hate to say I kind of became a statistic. Like, out of those 32 years, approximately about a year, not all together, about a year and a half, I spent them in jail. And I hate to say that, but at the same time, I'm not, because it's not my fault, because it's like over petty crime, right? Like smoking weed habitually, driving on a suspended license, also habitually, selling cocaine, murder, I mean, just small-time crimes in Little Rock. You know, small time stuff. You know what I'm saying? It was just like, it was just some bullshit. You know? But at all those times, you know what I'm saying? All those collective months all together. One thing that I am proud of, and I really want a big round of applause, is I never once got raped while I was in here. Not once. And I mean, that's a big accomplishment because look, I'm all about like 120 pounds. Like, I mean, I'm worth like 7 ramen noodles. I mean, it's like not, you know, I mean, I was really, really, but what did happen, I did get beat up habitually. It happened all the time. Like, they tend not to like big words like, stop that. Or no, I'm not a homosexual. Yes, it's still gay if you're in jail, you know, I mean, stuff like that, you know, stuff like that. But I made it out, and here I am, telling jokes about it, and shit feels great. It's great. Some people didn't make it this far. Anybody ever put a job? Shame on you guys. Shame on you. This is a tough economy. You know what? I've never quit a job. You know why? Because I've got fired from every one of those bitches. Every single time. You know how hard it is to get a job? Getting a job is a lot of work. You gotta fill out all those applications. You gotta repeatedly put the same stuff over, put the same lying ass contacts down. This ain't my mom. They have the same last name, so small town. Small town. And job application is a lot of hard work. Then you gotta, if you ain't got no car, you gotta pay somebody to take you to work. Then you gotta have gas money if you do have a car. I'm pretty confident the person that says it takes money to make money was probably looking for a damn job. And here you guys going around quitting those things all willy-nilly and shit. Damn. Crazy. Is anybody here for my job? No. Probably because I ain't got no damn job. But I just started doing comedy not too long ago. I'm already doing crazy shit like smoking crack. Okay, wrong crowd. No crack smokers in the house? I'm joking, guys. These are jokes. These are jokes. I've been smoking that shit. I'm joking, listen. No, I'm joking. These are really jokes, guys. It was funny because is there any law enforcement in the house tonight? Okay, cool. Is there any crack dealers in the house? I told that joke over in Hot Springs, and the police officer hopped out of nowhere, and he was like, "I am, son, and you smell just like marijuana." I was like, "No, sir." I said, "Haven't you heard?" So this is that new cologne all those rappers are wearing. It's called Lab Pack. It's only for niggas, so. But no, I'm joking. I mean, I don't smoke crack. I mean, for real. These are all jokes. This is all an act. These glasses aren't even real. I'm not even a black person. I'm just a black guy in a white person's costume. Like, after this show, I'll unzip this black man costume, strap on my cowboy boots, I'll hop in my pickup truck, pop a couple Zans, drive on down to the lake. Isn't that what you white people do to the lake? Start a bonfire or something. Okay, I'm joking. These glasses are real. Where did it go? So, I know what this lady was thinking. She was like, "Man, that's a handsome black guy. But man, what shade of black is he?" But if you must know, I have unveiled a blackness color wheel. So on this blackness color wheel, I fall right in between Akon Black and Wesley Snipes Black. And it's beautiful. Because I can have sex with the whitest white woman you can think of. Taylor Swift! That's what you're thinking. Yeah. Alright. Taylor Swift, right? Crispy white. Snow Black man, if you're standing next to her, you're going to get 40 years. But I can have sex with the whitest white woman you can think of, and that baby is still going to come out Tyrese Black. I like to call it Baby Boy Black. It's a new color. It's a new color. Man, yeah, I like telling jokes. It's pretty cool.